In the interrogation room, there are few bright lines to tell detectives what they can and cannot do. Is a 24-hour interrogation too long? Can police use sleep deprivation to get a suspect to cooperate? One of the few clear guidelines is the Miranda warning.
Once they are read those rights, if the suspect invokes the right, says, "I want a lawyer," those are the magic words. The interrogation stops.
Or does it? A recent U.S. Supreme Court case shows how the individual's right to stop an interrogation is being reshaped. One day in 1997, a migrant farm worker was riding a bicycle through this field in Oxnard, California. Oxnard police thought the man was a drug dealer and stopped him. As it turns out, they had the wrong guy. But by the time they realized that, it was too late.
Entonces, cuando la segunda vez que me tiró al suelo,
the second time he knocked me down, I heard him yelling to the other officer, his partner, who was a woman, saying to her that I had taken his gun and she should shoot me. Then the woman shot me. I can't remember how many times.
One bullet entered in one side of the temple and came out the other. It tore one eye out and then severed the optical nerve in the other. The second bullet, we believe, then hit his spine at about mid-back, and he became instantly paralyzed.
The interrogation of Oliverio Martinez began the moment he was put into an ambulance. Sergeant Ben Chavez, the supervisor of the officer who fired the shots, jumped in the ambulance with a tape recorder. Martinez was bleeding from 5 gunshot wounds and expected he was going to die.
Okay, mire, yo quiero saber si usted se sacó la pistola de la policía.
Yo no te digo nada hasta que no me cures.
Mire, dígame qué pasó. Yo quiero saber. Mire, usted, ¿no quieres que la policía sabe qué pasó con usted?
No, me duele nada, mi madre.
Señor, si vas a morir.
The interrogation continued in the ER. Sometimes over the objections of the attending doctors. The police knew he wasn't the drug dealer they were looking for, but they wanted to find out what happened in the field. Martinez confessed to taking the gun, but he now says it was a lie, and he only admitted to it so he could get medical treatment.
Yo quiero que me cure, okay, por favor.
Sí, mire, él está haciendo todo por usted ahorita. Pero dígame, ¿qué pasó? La pistola, dígame qué pasó.
Yo la saqué la pistola.
¿De las cintas de la policía?
Sí.
¿Sí? ¿Cómo?
Martinez is suing the Oxnard police, claiming his Fifth Amendment civil rights, among others, were violated. The facts of the case are beyond dispute. The police continued to ask questions over Martinez's pleas to stop. The legal implications of the case, however, are profound. Martinez's lawyer says that the meaning of Miranda hangs in the balance. Does Miranda give individuals the power to stop a persistent, even coercive interrogation?
The law has been very clear for many years. Once you say, "I don't want to speak," that's the end of it. And Officer Chavez should have known that once he kept questioning after Mr. Martinez said, "Leave me alone, I don't want to talk," that's it. The game's over. He should have stopped.
Not so fast, says the government. Miranda rights do not protect suspects in the interrogation room, but only defendants in court. According to this theory, because Martinez was never charged with a crime, his Fifth Amendment rights were not violated.
The correct statement of the law is, you have the right to remain silent. Anything you say can and will be used against you in a court of law. So it's the entire concept of the Fifth Amendment protection that is an issue here, not the simple statement that you have the right not to speak.
Samuel Paz believes a victory for the government adds muscle to police interrogation power. In a case where police believe the interrogation will not be used in court, if they're trying to get information about a third party, for example, then the police would have the green light to override a suspect's pleas to stop.
It just would invite intentional violations of the law by saying to police officers, it's okay to use coercion, even torture, even abuse, to get a statement, because after all, we're not going to use it in a criminal case against this person. We just want to get the information. And that, I think that would be a terrible step back into the past.
A severely divided U.S. Supreme Court disagreed with Paz, holding that Oxnard police had not violated Martinez's Fifth Amendment rights, and remanding the case back to the lower courts for further hearings. As for Oliverio Martinez, his chance encounter with police left him paralyzed from the waist down and blind in both eyes. His lawsuit deals primarily with charges of excessive force. After all, it was bullets, not questions, that severed his spine. But the legal questions surrounding his interrogation have the widest implications for American criminal justice. Law professor Stephen Drizin says this case shows how fuzzy the lines can sometimes be in the interrogation room and how that ambiguity can be exploited.
Because there are no bright line rules, and because when these cases come to court, we don't have a record of these conversations, most of them are not taped, police officers are willing to push the envelope because they know when the case comes to court that a judge or a jury is far more likely to believe their memory of the events than the suspect's memory of the events.